Do you read in Korean? Reading has been an important part of my life and my language learning journey. I have always been a very creative person with a big imagination, so reading was always like putting batteries in my brain and turning on a theater screen inside. It came to a point where I had to stop myself so I wouldn't spoil any books or stories that I liked, and even that didn't stop the fully scripted movie-like dreams. In this channel, I have shared with you part of my process of reading books to improve my Korean, and so the videos aren't updated to the strategies I use nowadays, I think they're a good reference point. This video can be considered a preface to those series, because today I don't come with book recommendation or reviews, but with an inside view of what goes in my brain while reading, and a little exercise that my brain does without asking to help you find the motivation to start reading or listening Korean literature. I have been drawn to science fiction for some years now, but I wasn't able to find translated sci-fi books from Korean authors, so reading wasn't something I was doing when I started diving into the culture. Last year, I found author Chun Sondan through a KBS radio program where they read different short stories from contemporary authors translating into many languages. I fell so in love with To the Desert, I even bought the Korean version of it, and though I still cannot understand very much of it, I have revisited the translated version a few times, always closing my eyes while I imagine the vast desert with an eye full of stars, the futuristic colonies, and the trips through the galaxy. As I said before, my brain runs so fast when reading books and stories, and one thing it always does is asking a lot of what ifs and creating different scenarios based on them. I didn't want to ruin my experience with To the Desert, but I couldn't help feeling I wanted to know what comes after. So I let my brain run wild and I came up with a dramatic prologue that I wish was a movie. Spoiler alert, you're warned. The story ends when the protagonist is getting ready to embark on a trip through the universe to find a new home for humanity. This is where my brain decided that it was a good idea to come up with a different ending. So the little exercise goes like this. She and her Hong Kong friend get to a ship to begin their mission as she thinks of the lies of her father and the dementia of her mother, hoping that a new planet will somehow make their lives better than they are now. They made the trip with no issues and finally land on the planet they're meant to evaluate. They get ready to explore and they decide to get into the task after getting approval to do so. Weirdly, the comms start glitching, but the communication isn't lost yet, so they just brush it off, promising to repair it once they come back. As they walk through the land, the night falls and the sky shows a billion blinking stars. They stop to watch them since they never were able to do so on Earth. It's so mesmerizing and gives them hope for a better future. Teardrops fall from their faces and they find themselves unable to move for what seems like an eternity. They realize that they must continue the mission so everyone on Earth can experience what they just did. They walk towards a sandy land and decide to take off their helmets since the air test came out clean. They sit down for a moment, contemplating the vast flora that displays in front of them, when suddenly the land begins to sink. They try to set free from their suits in hope that it's easier to get out of the trap, but as if the land knew what they were trying to do, the pressure around them increases and they cannot move anymore. It's like the planet is trying to eat them. As they sink slowly into the land, she realizes that the desert and the longing her father felt cannot be recovered. Humans lost them when they poisoned Earth and will never see them again. It's the revenge of nature, or maybe the revenge of something bigger than them. I hope you have enjoyed this little inside view into my reading process and that it helps you find the motivation to start reading or listening Korean literature. There are a lot of free resources available to do so that you might find very handy, so remember to check them out. Thank you for watching. See you next time.